Hello, viewing several. Here we are again. We all know why we're here. Time to get swifty. Do the thing.
I'm 37.
What?
I'm 37. I'm not old.
So, today, we are finally arriving at Taylor Swift's 2022 release, Midnight. And I've been recommended on multiple occasions by all of the very helpful, very well-informed commenters and subscribers that it should be the 3 a.m. version, as well as also recommending tracks that are part of the, I think, Till Dawn release. So basically I'm going to cover all the tracks on the 3 a.m. / Till Dawn version, split it into two parts because it's quite a lot of material there. So I think the first part will be the original standard release, and then all of the extras that came in 3 a.m. and Till Dawn will be covered in part two. So yeah, without much further ado, let's get to it. Hoping that the headphones last the whole while, because they are a bit cheap and cheerful, and an hour and 20 plus, hour and a half probably, they may well go off. 90%. All right, we may be in luck. Okay, so we will kick things off with the opening track, Lavender Bones. Also, there may well be a fair amount of puffing and sipping during this one because it's quite a long thing to get through, so yeah, I'll try and edit it out obviously if it interferes. Anyway, let's go. Opening strong. Ah, that had loads of elements that were very pleasing. Everything from the, you know, the lead up to the chorus, that, just, yeah, that was very, very enjoyable. Really fun production choices. Obviously a way more poppy sensibility than I've heard in folklore of Evermore. But that's what kind of thing I was expecting. So, very strong opener. Like that a lot. Okay, moving on. Track 2, Maroon. Oof. Love that.
When the morning came, we were cleaning incense off your vinyl shelf, cause we lost track of time again. Laughing with my feet in your lap, like you were my closest friend. And I chose you, the one I was dancing with in New York. No shoes, the dark and the sky, and it was the burgundy on my t-shirt when you splashed your wine into me, and how the blood rushed into my cheeks so scarlet.
Tone of her voice and the lyrics and this production.
Silence came, we were shaking, blind and hazy. How the hell did we lose sight of us again? Awake with your memory over me, that's a real fucking legacy. Legacy. And awake with your memory over me, that's a real fucking legacy. To leave the when you splashed your wine into me, and how the blood rushed into my cheeks so scarlet. It was my world. I saw my collarbone, the rust that grew between telephones, the lips I used to call home so scarlet. It was my world. It was my world.
Ooh, yes, like that a lot. That. The production style there, it felt darker. I mean, I literally just had images in my head of like scenes, whether it was the scene described in, you know, staying up late at night in the room or being out dancing, just being awash in like neon and almost Blade Runner-esque in terms of its sort of grim beauty. And in terms of some of the, like the beats and the overall production feel, I immediately thought of churches for some reason. I don't know if anybody gets what I mean there. But yeah, that was a great song. Really enjoyed that. All right, moving on. Track 3, Antihero. Okay, I have heard this one. I don't know where, but I've heard it played somewhere.
I should not be left to my own devices. They come with prices and vices. I end up in crisis. All this time. I wake up screaming from dreaming. One day I'll watch as you're leaving. Cause you got tired of my scheming. For the last time. It's me. Hi. I'm the problem. It's me.
I'd never have caught this if I'd taken the time to really listen.
It's me. Hi. I'm the problem. It's me. At tea time, everybody agrees. I'll stare directly at the sun, but never in the mirror. It must be exhausting, always rooting for the anti-hero.
odd note, but I also appreciate anti-hero instead of anti-hero. She thinks I left them in the will. I'm the problem, it's me. Hi. Everybody agrees. Ooh. I like what you did there. It was bound to happen at some point that I come across a track that I'd actually heard of hers, like, regularly. I mean, I've got a feeling this is something that is on one of many playlists that my wife procured. She's got very eclectic taste. She puts all kinds of stuff on there, everything from classics, you know, Sam Cooke through to Taylor Swift, through to Lewis Capaldi, over to Elvis. I mean, all kinds of stuff gets played on there, and I definitely had heard that chorus more than once, so that was already in there. But I'd never actually sat down and properly listened to it. So I'm glad I did, because again, fantastic lyrics, just a great vibe. Already, this album has got a brilliant vibe to it. Considerably more poppy, and obviously would, you know, not be out of place in any kind of setting where you need music that's got a beat to it, and but still evocative and really interesting. Okay. Track 4, Snow on the Beach. Oh, featuring soon to be featured artist on the channel, Lana Del Rey.
One night, a few moons ago, I saw flecks of what could have been lights, but it might just have been you passing by unbeknownst to me. Life is emotionally abusive and time can't stop me quite like you did. And my flight was awful, thanks for asking. I'm unglued thanks to you, and it's like snow at the beach, weird but fucking beautiful, flying in a dream.
With the lyrics, snow on the beach, weird but fucking beautiful.
But it's coming down, no sound, it's all around, like snow on the beach. My smile is like I want a contest, and to hide that would be so dishonest. And it's fine to fake it till you make it, till you do. Till it's true, now it's like snow at the beach, weird but fucking beautiful, flying in a dream, stars by the pocket full, you wanting me tonight feels impossible, but it's coming down, no sound, it's all around, like snow on the beach. Are flying saucers from another planet. Now I'm all for you like Janet. Can this be a real thing? Can it? Are we falling like snow at the beach? Weird but fucking beautiful. Flying in a dream. Stars by the pocket full. It's coming down, it's coming down, it's coming down, it's coming down.
Yeah, that was lovely. Again, lyrically, beautiful imagery brought up, and had a real dreamlike quality to it. That was lovely. I really can't wait to check out Lana Del Rey in more detail as well. Great stuff. Moving on to track 5, You're on Your Own, Kid.
Summer went away, still the yearning stays. I play it cool with the best of them. I wait patiently, he's gonna notice me.
I love the production choices when you hear that sort of muted in the background. I play my songs in the parking lot. I'll run away. I hosted parties and starved my body like I'd be saved by a perfect kiss. The jokes weren't funny. I took the money. My friends from home don't know what to say. I looked up. Quite an abrupt ending there, but wow, really, I love the way that it still managed to build even towards the end, and all of the production choices and the beat and the tone. It's unmistakably, you know, poppy, electronic, whatever. You can definitely dance to it if you've a mind to, but it's still really broody and dark for the most part, lyrically and just thematically. It just feels that way. Okay, on to track 6, Midnight Rain.
Pain, he wanted a comfortable, I wanted that pain. He wanted a bread, I was making my own name. Chasing that fame, he stayed the same. All of me changed like midnight.
Alright, Cher.
My town was a wasteland. Cages full of fences, pageant queens and big pretenders. But for some, it was paradise.
Pain. He wanted a comfortable, I wanted that pain. He wanted a bride, I was
making. That's a very interesting choice for the chorus.
Chasing that fame, he stayed the same. All of me changed like midnight.
It came like a postcard. Picture perfect, shiny family, holiday, peppermint candy. But for him, it's every day. And the life I gave away. Cause he was sunshine, I was midnight pain. He wanted a comfortable, I wanted that pain. He wanted a bride, I was making my own name. Chasing that fame, he stayed the same. All of me changed like midnight. I guess sometimes we all get some kind of haunted, and I never think of him except on midnights like this. Midnights like this.
Okay, pretty classic theme and style of love song, but really interesting choices there, particularly that, you know, I joked Cher, but you know, that electronic modulated thing in the intro and, well, I said chorus, pre-chorus is probably more accurate, but no, that was really interesting. Moving swiftly on to track 7, question, ...
Good girl, sad boy, big city, wrong choices. We had one thing going on. I swear that it was something, cause I don't remember who I was before you painted all my nights a color I have searched for since. But one thing I've
after another fucking situation, circumstances, miscommunications, and I have to say, by the way, I just may like some explanations. Can I ask you a question? Did you ever have someone kiss you in a crowded room? And every single one of your friends was making fun of you. But 15 seconds later, they were clapping too. Then what did you do? There was one drink after another, fucking politics and gender roles, and you're not sure, and I don't know. Got swept away in the gray. I just may like to have a conversation. Can I ask you a question? Did you ever have someone kiss you in a crowded room? And every single one of your friends was making fun of you.
Up the gear.
And every single one of your friends was making fun of you. But 15 seconds later, they were clapping too. Then what did you do?
How'd you get the clapping?
Did you leave a house in the middle of the night? Did you wish you'd put up more of a fight? When she said it was too much, do you wish you could still touch her? Just a question.
Yeah, another beautiful slice of pop perfection. This is really good. Even the songs like, frankly, that song and Midnight Rain are good. They are enjoyable. There's nothing wrong with them at all. They're only a little, they're borderline generic, but a good kind of generic. It's still good stuff. It's still beautifully produced. It has fun little moments. It lyrically is always in the stories that it tells. It's really good stuff, but not quite as impactful or memorable. Although I don't know, actually, maybe a question I like more than I'm letting on. I think actually, particularly towards that end, that last little kick in the last chorus. You know, save it for the final thoughts, Nick. Cool. Okay, moving on to Vigilante Shit. Okay.
Draw the cat eyes sharp enough to kill a man. You did some bad things, but I'm the worst of them. Sometimes I wonder which one will be your last lie. Say looks can kill, and I might try. I don't dress for women, I don't dress for men. Lately I've been dressing for revenge. I don't start shit, but I can tell you how it ends. She needed cold hard proof, so I gave her some. She had the envelope, where you think she got it from? Now she gets the house, gets the kids, gets the pride. Picture me thick as thieves with your ex-wife on the weekends. She don't dress for friends. Lately she's been dressing for revenge. Ladies always rise above. Ladies know what people want. Someone sweet and kind and fun. The ladies simply hide in love. Well, he was doing lines and crossing all of mine. Someone told his white collar crimes to the FBI. Don't get sad, get even. On the weekends, I don't dress for friends. Lately, I've been dressing for revenge.
Oh, that's probably the sexiest track I've heard her do. Wow, that was great. That was very minimal production. Just that little, the minimal beat, just letting her voice do most of the work in that sultry tone, and just telling that brilliant story of like being a honey trap and being a, you know, getting back at this guy and in cahoots with the ex-wife. And yeah, that was really, really fun and undoubtedly, you know, seductive. Despite the subject matter, it was a very seductive tone. That's I think I'll just have a little drink. Cool off a little. Okay, moving on. Track 9, Bejeweled.
Baby love, I think I've been a little too kind. Didn't notice you walking all over my peace of mind. And the shoes I gave you as a present. Putting someone first only works when you're in their top five.
Oh, and by the way, these lyrics.
I'm going out tonight. Best believe I'm still bejeweled. When I walk in the room, I can still make the whole place shimmer. And when I meet the band, they ask, do you have a man? I can still say I don't remember. Familiarity breeds contempt. Don't put me in the basement when I want the penthouse of your heart. Diamonds in my eyes. I polish up real, I polish up real nice. Baby boy, I think I've been too good of a girl. Too good of a girl. Did all the extra credit, then got graded on a curve. I think it's time to teach some lessons. I need you my world. Have you heard?
Jesus, these lyrics.
Claim the land. And I miss you. But I miss sparkling. Best believe I'm still bejeweled. When I walk in the room, I can still make the whole place shimmer. What's a girl gonna do? A diamond's gotta shine. Best believe I'm still bejeweled. When I walk in the room, I can still make the whole place shimmer.
This is such a good album. Just basically my previous self, the one who was really against anything pop music orientated, would have just heard the beat or heard the production and just gone, nah, just dismissed it out of hand. Wouldn't have even given it a second. But you listen to it, you listen to it, the production itself is just great fun. It's really inventive, it's very catchy, obviously. But the lyrics, and there's so much playfulness there and humour, and it's just great. It's just great fun to listen to. Yeah, I really wish I hadn't been so instantly dismissive just because it's popular. Again, don't get me wrong, there's plenty of popular music that I don't have a lot of time for. But right now, with this, I'm really glad that I decided to give it a chance and properly listen to it. Okay, on to track 10, Labyrinth. You remind me of the babe.
It only hurts this much right now.
Sound effects messing with me a bit.
Oh,
can't get used to that sound.
I'm falling in love. I thought the plane was going down. How'd you turn it right around?
I'm falling in love. Oh no, I'm falling in love again.
Okay, that's a pretty interesting soundscape that they made there. That really, that was going, seemed to be travelling from here to here. That was a little bit distracting. Still pretty good, still enjoyable. Don't know, certainly didn't hit as much as, you know, something like Bejeweled or even Question. But still, fun to listen to, interesting. Okay, on to track 11, Karma. I've heard it's a bitch.
You're talking shit for the hell of it. Addicted to betrayal, but you're relevant. You're terrified to look down. And I keep my side of the street clean. You wouldn't know. Know the cash ain't the only price. It's coming back around. Flexing like a goddamn acrobat. Me and Karma vibe like that. Ask me what I learned from all those years. Ask me what I earned from all those tears. Ask me why so many things, but I'm still here. Cause Karma is the thunder rattling your ground. Karma's on your scent like a bounty hunter. Karma's gonna track you down, step by step from town to town. Karma is my boyfriend. Karma is a guy.
Yeah, again, another fun, poppy track. Interesting message. Very catchy and upbeat when it came to the chorus. Again, not... again, I don't like using the word generic, but there definitely are tracks, which I think is inevitable with any album that's got quite a few tracks on it. In the case of, you know, the deluxe version, ultimately, that I'm listening to. There's going to be tracks that are like, that's good, but it's not quite as good as the other one, so... why have it? Almost filler, but a little bit too fun and a little bit too interesting to be just filler. So maybe I'm just being too picky and being too finicky about it. Okay, on to track 12, Sweet Nothing.
I spy with my little tired eye, tiny as a firefly, a pebble that we picked up last July. Down deep inside your pocket, we almost forgot it. Does it ever miss Wicklow sometimes? They said the end is coming, everyone's up to something. I found myself around and home to your sweet nothings. Outside they push and shoving, you're in the kitchen humming. All that you ever wanted from me was sweet nothing. Industry disruptors and soul deconstructors and smooth talking hucksters out glad handing each other. And the voices that implore you should be doing more. To you I can admit that I'm just too soft for all of it. They said
the end is coming. Everyone's up to something. I find myself a running home to your sweet nothings. Outside they're pushing, shoving. You're in the kitchen humming. All that you ever wanted from me was sweet nothing.
I like that. That was really, that was very, well, as the title suggests, you know, very sweet, very simple, beautifully delivered message about just contentment, I guess, of having somebody in your life that just by their presence can make all the bullshit, all the nonsense, all this, the stuff, which I imagine is quite a lot for somebody in like Taylor's position, but for anybody really, just makes all that stuff go away, and just by being there makes everything better. It's nice when you have that. Love you, honey. Okay, let's close out the standard edition with the 13th track, Mastermind.
Once upon a time, the planets in the fates and all the stars aligned. You and I ended up in the same room at the same time. What if I told you none of it was accidental, and the first night that you saw me, nothing was gonna stop me? I laid the groundwork, and then, just like clockwork, the dominoes cascaded in a line. What if I told you I'm a mastermind?
Seductive and sinister at the same time.
'Cause I'm a mastermind. If you fail to plan, you plan to fail. Strategy sets the scene for the tale.
Again, with the
I'm the wind in our free flowing sails, and the liquor in our cocktails. It was all my design. 'Cause I'm a mastermind. Play with me as a little kid, so I've been scheming like a criminal ever since to make them love me and make it seem effortless. This is the first time I felt the need to confess, and I swear I'm only cryptic and Machiavellian 'cause I can. So I told you none of it was accidental, and the first night that you saw me, nothing was gonna stop me. I laid the groundwork and then saw a wide smirk on your face. You knew the entire time. You knew that I'm a mastermind, and now you're mine. Yeah, all you did was smile, 'cause I'm a mastermind.
That's a pretty solid closer, in my humble. Managing to make something that's, you know, fun, seductive, but also kind of sinister, but in a very enjoyable way. I mean, let's be honest, for people of a certain proclivity, you wouldn't mind being the pawn in her mastermind game. Not really. Again, still love you, just saying. Okay, so that concludes part one. The standard edition, the original release of Midnights. Stay tuned for part two. Goodbye for now.
Listen, strange women lying in ponds distributing thought is no basis for a system of government.